connected. I'm trying to do multiple things at the same time with a almost dead iPad. So, as you can hear, the baby started whining as soon as I started talking. I'm home by myself. Emily is with her sister. I don't know where. And I'm trying to get onto my page on my iPad. And my family was using my iPad. And whoever used it last, Romel, left it on the couch, just draining. And so now that I need it, it's almost dead. I have it plugged in, but it's not plugged in into an official like charging thing. I gotta use what I got over here. So hopefully it doesn't die while we're live, because once it dies, then I can't see all your comments and who's popping on. And I apologize for anybody who gets offended by crying babies in the background while moms are trying to cook dinner. But she's just gonna have to whine there, because this shouldn't take too long as I can get this done. So we're just gonna do basic hamburgers with cheese on it, but we're not gonna use flour. We're gonna use almond flour. I took out my shredded mozzarella out of the freezer just now, so it's still kind of hard. Hi everybody. Hello. I see all of your comments. I do have cheddar, and that one is not frozen, so I'm gonna leave that in the fridge, or it's gonna melt because it's hot today. Hi Tanya. Hi Maury. I'm gonna say hi to everybody. Crystal, Laura, Tammy, Rollin, hello. Did I miss anybody? Maury, Tanya, Magdalia, hello, I see you. Okay, so I have the pan already heating up. I have 2 eggs in the bowl. I have about 2 pounds of ground beef in here. I'm gonna make like just a basic hamburger. I was gonna do like the meatballs with the little mozzarella square inside, so it has a melty cheese in the center, but I'm like, I don't have time to make that bougie stuff right now with the baby. Just me and the baby home. This is minced onion. I just put Himalayan pink salt from Rollin. Thank you, Rollin. I'm just shaking some minced onion in here, like a lot. Since I don't have that Lipton onion soup mix, we're going to do minced onion. Garlic powder, we're going to add that. This is going to be a real simple, simple hamburger dinner. And then I'm going to be steaming some... hi, Melissa. Hi, Dana. I know, I was going to do cheese stuffed, but... cheese inside or cheese on top, same thing. So I'm just gonna use, I don't know, a couple teaspoons of garlic powder. This is the fine garlic powder, so it always gets like rock hard. And so I have 2 eggs in here. I'm just adding my seasonings, real simple. Minced onion, salt, pepper, gonna add pepper, real basic stuff, nothing too complicated. And then normally I would do this in the micro-pro grill, but today I think it's gonna just be faster because I can make them bigger right on the stovetop. So I have the pan heating up on high. If the baby wasn't eating this, I would put crushed red pepper, but she is. And oh, you guys probably just saw my armpit there. Sorry. I need a thing. I'm trying to like focus on you guys and not her, because the moment she sees me focus on her, she's gonna go for it. So I put 2 eggs in here. See, you see, which may have been too much, and I really don't want to have to shove my hands in here. I hate doing that. Sometimes you just gotta do it. Hi Alex, hi Christine, hi Joanne, hi everybody. I haven't done dinner too much this week. Yeah, I did breakfast the other day. I'm gonna add some more minced onion. This is a lot of hamburger, but I'm gonna make these patties kind of big. Oh, this pan is hot. And I'm just going to put a little bit of almond flour, because we're not using regular flour. Because we are going to try and do the stick to the keto life. I'm going to put maybe... this is... I'm holding a 1/4 cup. But I'm not going to put that much. I'm just going to kind of shake it on there. Yes, Lisa, just making burgers. And I'm going to top it with shredded cheese. If I had more time and the baby wasn't being super duper whiny, I might have to get in here with my hands, guys. I would probably do the cheese stuffed one, like the cheese stuffed meatball thing I saw on Facebook. You guys seen that one? Hi, Jen. I'm making hamburgers. Something basic. I'm going to put the rest of this 1/4 cup in here. Did you guys see it? It was like, it's like meatballs, and they put a little square of mozzarella cheese inside, and they wrap it up, and then they... cook it. I can't remember how they made it, but they did that. And I was, in my mind, I was thinking I'm going to do that. But it's just, when you got a little one that intermittently starts whining when you're cooking, I can't, I don't have the time. I'm going to add Parmesan cheese because I love it. So I'm just making any kind. As usual. Oh my goodness, look at that long name. How do I pronounce that? Toafili Moenga. I hope I said that right. You haven't caught my live since the beginning of the year. Oh my gosh, Tanya, that's a long time. Oh, here we go. Wow. I hope I said that right. That was a challenging one. I'm just gonna say Danielle. It does. It smells yummy. I added a little bit of Parmesan cheese. I would say maybe like 2 tablespoons. So we are trying to do the keto thing. The keto life. We are going to try and stick to that. And I am going to have to get down and dirty in this thing. Hi, Rosie. I was outside. I was in the pool for a little bit because it was a little hot today. I'm going to put a little bit more because I love Parmesan cheese in my hamburgers. Ever since this whole introduction to keto thing, Parmesan cheese has been one of my favorite things. And you know what, Lisa? The reason I probably look extra brown is because after I take a shower now, I use body oil. And I forgot that I had this particular oil from my friend. She's a pure romance lady. But they sell this body oil that you put on after you take a shower. And you have to put it on very sparingly or else you're going to be... It's not a greasy oil, but if you put too much, just like any lotion or oil, when your skin has absorbed all the oil, you're going to have a slickiness to it. I'm going to stick my hands in here, okay? So if you guys are grossed out by me handling some meat, look away. Look away! I got to. Sometimes you just got to get down and dirty. And I cut my nails today because, you know, I used to get my nails done before. Now I just, I don't know. It's not my focus anymore, although I miss it. So I put this body oil, and I'll show it to you guys after I pile with this live so that you guys can see it. But it's, you know what? It really brings out the golden toastiness. So I look extra brown, yeah, today. So I'm just going to smash this by hand. However, it doesn't have to be perfs. Just going to smush it. We do have a hamburger press, but I don't want to have to make more dishes today. And I'm going to poke a hole in the center like that. The pan is really, really hot. I've had it on high heat since the beginning of this video. Baby is going to keep whining until I'm done, guys. Until I'm done. So we're playing with meatballs now. Trying to make it nice and pretty. Smush it and put a dimple. Let's see if this works here like this. And there's no oil in the pan, by the way. Hi, Michelle. You like my tan? You know what I started noticing, though, and Romel and my family noticed it? If you look really, really closely, I have splotchiness on my face. It's like I'm missing melanin in certain areas of my face. And I want to tell you guys right now, this hamburger smells really, really good. So I'm going to steam. Gosh, let me do that after this. I'm poking a little dimple just right in the center, and I'm throwing it in the hot pan. Hi, Melanie. If you see me looking the other way, it's because I'm reading the iPad, which I hope does not die on me. Christy, I'm getting dark. So is Emily. I know. And you know what the bad thing is? We don't really use sunscreen. And we don't... When we go out in the pool... Rosie. When we go out in the pool, we usually go out like after 3. Like 2, 3. Like afternoon. Because it is just too dang hot when you go out there at high noon, which is... also the worst time to be in the sun. So we go out late, and if you guys notice the picture I posted, I have a Tupperware umbrella. I have a Tupperware umbrella out there. I'm using my hands to push the burgers around. It's not sticking to the pan, this hot pan. Hi, Victoria. I have a Tupperware umbrella that my mom MacGyvered to our clothesline so it doesn't fly away. So she actually tied a dog leash, wrapped it to the inside part of the hi Kupuna, oh my god. She strapped it to the inside of the umbrella and then attached it to the link, the fence that's back there, so even if the wind tries to pick it up, it ain't going nowhere. So it's anchored down, and then we kind of close pin the canopy down. Oh, high number sunblock. Oh crap, I hate using sunblock. It totally messes up my skin. Like, it makes it all the time cloggy. Oh, look, it's Jay. We're making hamburgers, Jay. I think I can fit one more. No, I'm not. Okay, let me wash my hands. Until the next round of meat squishing. Yeah, she does, and I know she can smell it. Can you guys see my pan? Hardly. Let me move this down. Flippin' burgers. Ooh, the almond flour is working great with keeping the burgers together. So I did not put any oil in here. I don't know what the percentage of fat is in these burgers, but whatever. I need my spoon rest. And then I also need to press start on this thing. I have cauliflower and broccoli in my smart multi-cooker, so I'm going to steam that for 12 minutes while this is cooking and dinner's going to be done. I will put cheese after. Oh, they have an ointment for that? How come I'm slapping it? Oh, because my meat likes to get beat. Me too, Jay. I cannot wait. So me and Jay are going to go have dinner tomorrow at Roy's Waikiki. Yes, where RJ works. Holla! So if you guys are ever in Waikiki, you guys got to go eat at Roy's. It is a five-star facility, so it's not a cheap place to eat. But it helps when your son works there. Because you get the hookups. I know. I'm waiting for Jay to go live. Jay. Stop that. According to my lying scale, it said I only lost 11 pounds, but the thing boo lied because my clothes fit a lot better. It might not fit a lot better in this coming weekend because I'm going to pig out. I'm going to have to stop the keto life for a couple days. Same panty. How much weight I lost? What is this? What color? Jay, when are you going to go live on your page, girl? And when are you going to show us that unicorn sprinkler because I really want to try that. Since Jay is on. Gotta poke a hole in the middle. Okay. I lost at least an Emily. Stop it. Should we match tomorrow? Okay, so I'm gonna put the cheese on very, very soon. Some is going to have cheddar and some is going to have mozzarella. If this will defrost in time, I pulled it out of the freezer just now. Jay, are you on keto? No, she not. You guys see her Instagram stories. Don't eras the kind of food she eat, the kind of stuff I know can. Actually, I could, but I choose not to. Should I put the cheese on while it's in the pan? Well, the reason I poke a hole in the middle is so that it's something I learned from my Tupperware class. When you cook it so that it kind of evens out, because if you don't poke a divot in it, what happens is it tends to like bulge or whatever it's called. That's what I was told. And I can see, I don't know if you guys can see, I'm trying to check, like this one right here, all the juices are coming out the hole. All the juices are coming out the hole, everybody. That's what happens when Jay pops on my lines. We go south real fast. I'm gonna kind of squish it down a little. Yeah, it does. The whole helps. So the whole makes all the juiciness, the stuff come out. I'm gonna squish it because nobody wants a burger that's like pink in the middle. I don't, anyways. Some people do. So it's still on high heat, and this is. God, I don't know what the name of this pan is, and the baby can hear me talking. She know I'm lying, so she don't cry. Your husband likes to poke your meat. Mine too. So Jay, when your husband doesn't poke your meat like every night or two nights or whatever, does he turn into a raisin too? Just asking for a friend. Is Paco on here? It's coming out the hole. Oh, he's on probation. What did he do? Did he buy another car? That's what I forgot to ask you. What he did? Ooh, these burgers is juicy. It's gonna be okay, baby. Mommy is cooking dinner. Let me flip this. Oh, MG, these look so good. Oh, he turned into a prune. Ooh, he must be pretty pruny now then if he's still on probation. Romel, I don't know about him. He de-raisin himself, so he not one raisin now. I know, he only likes organic. Erica, I know. All because I was poking holes in my meat. So I'm smushing it like this. And then I just poke a little divot hole in the center like that. That's what I was taught, so. And so far, it seems to be helping with the shrinkage. Nobody likes it when the meat shrinks. Do that, bro. That we gotta take care of the kids, like, legit. So Romel went scuba diving this morning, and guess where he's staying right now? Yeah, at the ocean. He's playing on top of the water today, now paddling. He was just in the water scuba diving earlier. So I'm gonna keep squishing these burgers because I can still see pink coming out the center hole. I don't want bloody. I'm just gonna push down. This is one of the benefits to the microflow grill, is you can have it sitting on the burgers. So it squishes out all the blood while it's cooking. And am I the only one, but like, you know, when I cook burgers, I have a tendency to end up cutting the burgers in half because I want to make sure it's not raw in the middle. I'm gonna cut this one in half because I want to make sure it's not. Oh, it's good. It's good. That one's going to be the baby. Oh, hello. It's down here. The Hello Kitty plate. So here's the babies. So it's cooked all the way through. It's not like dried out or anything. Can you guys see? So there's hers. And I'm going to sprinkle some cheese on top. So this should be, because it's still hot. I was going to put it like while I was in a pan, and I'm going to do that for the rest. Hold on, baby. Oh my God. How long have I been on? 20 minutes. Oh my God. I went to Craftsway today to go get some more hair clips because all my, I don't know what happened to all my other hair clips that have flowers in it.
Can you guys see the flowers?
So I went to Craftsway and I ate to go pick that up. So the cheese is slowly melting on the baby's one. Christine sounds like Orion. Yeah. I mean, at least she's not like, oh, I don't want to speak too soon. I'm going to jinx myself. Sometimes she does this like blood curdling. Oh my God. The world is coming to an end kind of thing. And I'm just like, what in the world is a problem, girl? She can smell it, I know. I gotta wait for it to cool off, though. Hi, Kayala. So her issue is she always is so anxious to eat the food. She cannot wait for the thing cool off and she burn herself. Okay, last one. So this was 2 pounds. So I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7, 8, 9, 10, something like that. Bye, Lisa. When are you going to show the baby, Jay? This thing smells super ono. I got to squeeze one more in here so I can put the bowl away. I just like throw it in there. I guess Faka is still working. Oh, you know what? He probably is. It's month end for him. Yes, that kind scream, Jay. That one. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Like, oh my God. Like, what's the problem? And the problem is they want you to carry them. So if my left bicep looks a little bit bigger than my right, it's because I was carrying her on my left arm. Bye, Jay. See you tomorrow. Let me know what time. So that you're not naked when I show up. Oh, I was gonna cover cheese, yeah. Let me put the cheese on top. You want the cheese on the top? Oh, the hamburger deluxe. I'm gonna just put cheese, sprinkle cheese on it. On the ones that are almost done. Yes, I know it would be easier if I had cheese slices, but I'm trying to avoid eating using those processed ones, the processed cheeses. So this is actually cheese that I grated myself. The rest of them are not ready. We're gonna squish, squish. I know it looks good, Jack. The burgers do look good. I'm just waiting for it to cool off a little bit so she can try it on camera. Since it's been a while since I had it on camera. It's not as hot right now. It's very, very cloudy. It looks like it's gonna start raining. And there is a slight breeze coming through, so I'm not like melting today. It's just the baby whining, that small kind, like it's like nails on a chalkboard for me right now. You guys know what I'm talking about. And you know, before I had Emily and Christine, your daughter, oh my God. See, Tanya, that's sometimes she has those moments. And in fact, she did that to me earlier today while I was freaking running errands. You know, while Ramel was scuba diving on his thing off. And it was just like, oh my God, honestly, why? Why are you doing that? So here's the finished one here. It smells really yummy. And I am going to put more cheese on it. I just didn't want to put too much and it ends up at the bottom of my pan. They did shrink a lot, yeah, these patties. I have the pan still on high heat, you guys. I never adjusted it down. So I'm just kind of moving them around. Okay, so there's that. Let me put some more cheese on top so it can keep melting because it looks super yummy. If I had mushrooms, I would totally saute the mushrooms in all this oil. But we don't have any more. I used them all up. Yes. Oh, I like, you know what? I should go find some aged cheese. But is it like, I don't know. It's probably going to be so expensive over here for us in Hawaii. So in a month, Ramel and I will be in Orlando visiting family right before Jubilee. Super excited. She's watching Coco. I know. I should go get her. You know, I just worry because this thing is sizzly. And I don't want her too close to the stove while this is like sizzling on the stovetop. You know what I mean? She's fine. She's in her playpen watching Coco. She's okay. I'll grab her as soon as I'm done sizzling burgers on the stove. Hi, Crystal. Ooh, Shirley, you love your Fridge Mart. Me too. Everybody should get at least one piece of Fridge Mart in your refrigerator in your kitchen to try it. You gotta do it quick because the sale is gonna end soon, guys. The extra large, by the way, ends tomorrow. So if you didn't get that, and the extra large one does not need a requirement to buy something first. You can just buy it outright for $25. So that's the benefit to that particular sale. And when you buy the extra large for $25, you can get a large for $20 because it qualifies for that. But if you want to do that, it's not online. You got to message me to order. I got to check my messages. Somebody's supposed to be coming over at 6 o'clock to buy some Tupperware from my stash. It's a family friend, family, extended family. So she called work now, I think, and she's on her way here to pick up some stuff. Oh, I heard the microwave. Yeah, the microwave went beep, yeah. Hi, Pat. Long time no see on live. Ooh, that one looks yummy. Ooh, I like when it has that brown, burnt look to it. When it's nice and crispy. Ah, see, the oil is starting to like pop a little bit. That's why I don't want the baby in here. Yeah, I'm gonna turn off the heat already. I like it when my burgers are like this. That's just me. I like that crunch, you know that crunch? So I did not use any flour or bread in these hamburgers. I used almond flour. And I don't think this plate is gonna be big enough for all of these burgers. Paka never come on yet, too, yeah, yet. Still, I mean. So dinner's almost done. Should be under 30 minutes, yeah? Is it under 30? What time now? Woo, 25 minutes. So I got my burgers done. The veggie steam. Hi, Ashley. This thing slipped right out of my hand. Okay, let's see. Moana. I know, I think she outgrew Moana. Now she's stuck on Coco. So she watches that all day long. She's focused on the TV. I turned this thing off already and it still scissoramas. You know, I could probably toss the veggies in this and brown it. But I won't, because then it's going to be, I'll be burping hamburgers for days. I'm going to go take out the steamed veggies next. Let me put this on the side. And then we're going to put mozzarella on this because we're out of cheddar. And this I took out of the freezer, guys. This is the cheese I shredded on that video I did probably months ago. Was it last month or the month before when I was showing you guys the grater? I grated like a crap ton of mozzarella. Hi, Susan. I love mozzarella. So there's Parmesan cheese in the hamburger mixture. But see, I put cornstarch so that it doesn't stick. And some people say that you don't need to do that because it won't. But you know, when I'm while I'm grating it, it's super humid here that the cheese tends to stick anyways. So the cheese is still frozen. The hamburgers are super hot. I just took it out of the pan. So I think it'll be good. It just needs to sit there like that. Susan, I just made hamburgers. So I just made hamburger patties with cheese. Keto friendly. So I used almond flour instead of regular flour. And then let me clean this up. So this is going to melt as it sits. This made a lot. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 patties. I did 2 pounds. I'm gonna put this here so I can take that out, and then let me wipe this down. I love these Norwex things. I just got this the other day, and God, I cannot remember what it's called. Oh, but it's supposed to replace paper towels. And it does pick up a lot of spilt, like if you spill water or whatever. Oh my God. So now I use this because it's smaller and it's easier to wash than the big rag that you normally see me using. But I still use that for wiping down the tables and stuff. So I did this for 12 minutes. This is just cauliflower and broccoli. So 12 minutes in the microwave, steamed. And I'm going to pour the hot water down the drain. So it's all nice and piping hot. So this took 12 minutes. Oh, hello. The camera's over here. Let me move you guys over here. There we go. So you guys can see this now. So there. That was 12 minutes. And what I'm going to do now at this point is I'm going to just put some Himalayan salt on it. Come on. Come on. Click. These salt grains are big, so it gets caught in this grinder. And some black pepper. And if you want, you can sprinkle cheese on it. Cheese on everything. Cheese is good. I like Parmesan cheese. So you can do cheese if you want to. But I'm going to leave this out to release all that steam. Because if not, it's going to overcook the veggies. So there it is. There's my steamed veggies and my patties. Hi, Koji. I missed you at fun night. I didn't realize you left. And I was like, Koji, pull a ticket. So there's my burgers. This one's still melting. It's going to keep melting. These are going to probably be for Ramel when he comes back from paddling. He can warm this up. Because this plate is microwavable. So you can throw that whole thing in the microwave. I'm going to get the baby now. I'm going to leave this out here. I'm going to get the baby. So she can try. Come on. Let's go, whiner. Come here, whiny baby. Baby. Hi, baby. Hi, baby. baby. Hi, baby. Hi, whiny baby. Say hi, everybody. Hi.
You want to try your burger? Hot.
Hot. Hot. Hot. Can you say hot?
Hot. Hot. Hi, Kelly. Thank you, Melissa. Ooh, Chris, garlic powder. That sounds good. The only thing is I have fine garlic powder, and I don't know. I'm kind of scared. I'm klutzy with that thing, and I'm scared that I'm going to, like, just drop, like, way too much on top. She knows it's coming, guys. Don't touch baby hot. You know what she likes? She likes cauliflower mash. Like, she will pound the heck out of that. Say hi. Hi. Say hi. Okay, now I'm getting hot because the steam is all up in my face. But I'm sure it's good for my pores. Oh, and I gotta show you guys that body oil I was talking about. That's what I use on my skin to keep it moisturized after swimming in the pool. And it also brings out your tan. Or tattoos. If you guys have tattoos, it actually makes your tattoos, it kind of revives them. More, please. Oh, there it went. She wants to suck the flavors out and then drop the meat. You don't want? What do you want? You want cheese? You want this? You want this? What do you want? Which one you want? This? Hot.
It's hot. Let me blow it. And then we're going to sign off because I'm going to make this video too long, people. People got stuff to do.
She has the two teeth on the top are coming out more. I just want to make sure it's not too hot for her. You're so heavy. More? More? No? You don't want? How about some cheese? Wanna try some cheese? I do not own the rights to the music, in case you guys can hear it. She's looking at herself on the iPad. Okay, more, more. You want this? No? That's a big one. See if you can do it. If it's too hot, she'll spit it out. I tell you, this kid, she likes cauliflower. Is it good? When I make it, it's cauliflower mash anyway, she likes it. She's kind of questioning. Do I like it? Do I not like it? Not sure. Yes? No? You want some more? Okay, you want cheese? Because mommy has to turn off the video now. She likes the cheese. So she likes dinner. She spit out the hamburger. I think she likes the flavor and doesn't want to chew on the meat. But we're going to go off and we'll see you guys. Oh, I don't know about tomorrow night. If I go live, we'll be out and about. So say bye. Say bye-bye. See you. Say bye-bye. We're going to log off. I'm going to feed baby and feed myself. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in today. Bye.